Greetings, I'm Professor Hobo, and welcome to another Hobo Techno's product review. In January, I did a full review of Ecoflow's new 7200 watt behemoth, the Delta Pro Ultra, and they also sent along with it their new smart home panel version 2. That's right here behind me. My Delta Pro Ultra at the time was a prototype model with some limitations, and they have since swapped it out for a pair of shiny new retail models so that I could demonstrate what this smart home panel can do and ask the big question, is it any good? Let's find out. Now the smart home panel 2, which I'll call the home panel from this point on, does require some installation. Now the amount of installation is really going to depend on what you're using it for. If you're installing it as a replacement to your existing breaker panel or alongside an existing one, how many circuits you plan to use it with, if you need to use both 120 and 240 volt service, which would be a big yes if you're using it for a home or in a garage, for example, to charge an electric vehicle. And the biggest pain point is going to be if you plan on having your Delta Pro Ultra or DPU, which I'll call it from this point forward, in the same location as the home panel or in a different location. Now, as for my installation difficulty, I'm going to consider it moderate since I will be requiring 240 volt service. And instead of replacing my existing breaker panel that's basically full of spaghetti wiring and stuck between wall studs too narrow to fit this new home panel, I'll be installing it alongside my current breaker box as a supplement to run just a few circuits. Over time, I'm likely to add additional circuits, but for this demonstration in this video, my plan is to install a single 240 volt 50 amp line that goes out to my full hookup RV site and a pair of 120 volt 20 amp lines that run the freshly installed outlets in my new lab addition, and that's the room next to this one. The rest of the building circuits that existed when I got here will remain in the old box. And I'm also going to install the Delta Pro Ultras in a separate room, so that's going to entail running some heavy-duty 50-amp cabling about 25 feet from their location in the next room over to where the Smart Home Panel 2 will reside next to my current breaker box, which is in this room. Now I need to make a disclaimer. Everything I'm going to talk about from this point forward is going to apply to the United States and other parts of North America that run on dual-phase 240 volt grid power at 60 hertz into residential properties. This install is also going to follow the local electrical codes, so what I do may not entirely apply to you if you live somewhere else. This review is not meant to substitute for professional advice from a certified electrician and is for entertainment purposes only. Anything you repeat in this video is at your own risk. Now that all that's out of the way, here's all the equipment I'll be installing over the next few days. We first have a pair of Ecoflow Delta Pro Ultras with a total inverter output of 14.4 kilowatts, and that will be at 240 volts. Since we do have a pair of 6 kilowatt batteries to go along with it, we'll have a total of 12 kilowatt hours available. I will expand on this capacity later. We of course have the Smart Home Panel 2, which comes shipped like this in one big piece. Now this bottom part is where up to 3 Delta Pro Ultras can plug in, and it can be separated and installed in a separate location, and this is what we're going to do. Note that if you do install this input box in a separate location, you're going to have to run some heavy-duty cabling. In my case, I'm going to run 6-gauge cabling because I have 2 Delta Pro Ultras. If you want to run 3 Delta Pro Ultra inverters, you're going to need 2-gauge cabling. So that's some pretty massive cabling. For my install, I'm going to be using 6-3 Romex. Also note that you're going to need to run an equal length of Category 6 or better Ethernet cable to digitally connect the DPU output box to the home panel. The home panel contains the brains of the unit along with a Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antenna. So where you install the home panel will need internet access to sync with the Ecoflow app. Now, if you don't plan to ever use the wireless features on the home panel, you can install this in an area without Wi-Fi, but you really should do a bench install, like install it like on a table like this first, so that you can get everything online, get it set up the way you want, which can only be done through their app. and you should do any firmware updates before you take the thing offline and do your permanent install. Now, last but not least, we have the Ecoflow power site display, which is right over here. It's basically just a giant Android tablet that lets you see in real time what's going on between the home panel and the DPU units. This way, you don't have to keep like looking on your phone, looking up the app. You can hang this on the wall. It's pretty neat. It's got this mount on the back, which is magnetic, so you can actually peel this thing right off the wall. See? Very cool. So I'm gonna go and put this up on the wall when I'm done to monitor everything going on. This is a wireless device and it does charge with USB-C, so you're gonna wanna place it permanently in a location that has some kind of power. So let's show you the before shot and explain what we're gonna do. And then I'll try getting some footage of the actual installation as it's happening. And when it's all done, we're gonna fire all this stuff up and run the home panel. The home panel does track usage over time, so I'm hoping to get at least a few days of data before this video has to come out. So let's go take a look at the old breaker panel and where we're going to go ahead and put the Delta Pro Ultras in their final resting place. Okay, let's start at a brief look at the home panel too before we fill it full of breakers and wires. So this is what it looks like naked. You can see it looks just like a regular circuit breaker panel, except a little fancier. Now, these are all controlled circuits, so you can tell it what to do through each one of these, which is pretty cool. So this bottom part, you can leave on if you're installing this all in one unit, or if you want to install your Delta Pro Ultras in a separate location, you need to take this box off with these wing nuts. Then take these four wires out, and this whole box will get installed in the location with your Delta Pro Ultras, and this gets installed where you're obviously where your power lines and everything and your circuits are. So this is what it looks like. It's actually really well built, nice and thick metal. Nice glass on the front, looks really nice. I don't know if the camera's catching it, but it is really nice, well designed. The door is held together with magnets, so it's nice and claspy, it works really well. This is the antenna, so this will transmit and receive the Wi-Fi outside of the metal box. So we move on over here to my circuit breaker panel. Now, this looks like a spaghetti mess because it is. It was like this when I bought the place, so don't blame me that it looks like crap. The only thing I've done since I've been here was I've added this slider in here with these 250-amp breakers. Now, what this does is the power coming in from the Ecoflow power kits or a transfer switch would come into here. And the grid power comes in through here. So you got these black and red wires. That's 240 volts from my power line coming into this breaker. And then you have power coming in these two lines on this breaker. And I can switch this back and forth, either have solar and battery power or grid power. And this will power the entire box either off a grid or off a solar. So currently I have 250 amp outlets. These three circuits aren't going to go anywhere. This double breaker here was just put in for my room addition next door. So these wires are nice and long, and the reason I want to move those is because those wires are nice and long. So the home panel is going to be mounted to this board, which hasn't been cut or anything. It's just up here for looks right now. We're going to cut this and stain it. Then we're going to put the home panel two up here. So we'll have the outputs going out through the top, and we'll have the inputs coming in through the bottom. Now you take a step out of the lab, you come into this new addition that I put on. This actually has, and you can see there's my professor's secret lab sign. And as you can see, this has an Ecoflow power kits, which is maxed out with 3 5-kilowatt-hour batteries. I'm gonna review this all separately next month. This is the area where the Delta Pro Ultras are gonna go. So we're gonna take the Delta Pro input box, put it here. Junction box will take the wires inside, and then it will run up and over and down into where that box is over there. But I am gonna have to run it up here, then down, and then over and up. So that's what we're gonna do. Okay. Work is in progress. We do have some lines. We got the hole in the wall here and the box in place, so we're getting there. All right, here we are, end of day one. This is the work that was done today. We got the conduit up in place, and that's running down through the wall going to the other side. Now, this junction box allows us to take wires from inside the box and put them through. And this bottom conduit is going to be replaced with something else tomorrow. You can see we've already moved a couple of breakers over. And don't have the grid hooked up yet. I'm currently powering everything in here off of solar. Oh, and I forgot to add, this is the conduit coming through the wall, which is gonna get wired down into this box. Okay, we have the input box done. It is wired up and gooped to the wall and ready to be plugged in. All you gotta do is put the faceplate on and we're ready to go.
Tomorrow.
Now that the installation is complete, let's check it out. So as I already demonstrated, this is the smart home panel too. You take this cover off, there's normally not a lot to see inside, but the four cables come in. plus the network cable, don't forget. So you actually have five cables that come in and connect to the box. Now, in order to bring the grid and generator in, you either need to punch your own holes through the sides or top. They also let you punch holes in the bottom. And eventually, I'm going to have a generator hook up here. I'm just going to use this box below, if you can see it, and move it up here. And then I could run another device as a generator on the input. Because I decided not to have the DPUs in the same room as the smart panel 2, because this is my main circuit box, so I didn't want to have these loud, noisy things in this room taking up a bunch of space. Now, having the two pieces separate actually made the installation significantly more difficult than it would have been to just keep everything in one place. It did take 1.5 people about 8 hours or 12 man hours from start to finish, then another couple of hours for me to program it and get everything online. You just don't flip a switch and the home panel starts working. You have to tell via the app every circuit you want to turn on and if that circuit's 120 or 240. For example, these two circuits are 240 volts and these two circuits are 120 volts. So I wanted to do a mix of both so that I could demonstrate how this thing works. Up here is the grid breaker. So this is the breaker coming in from the grid. And then if you wanted a generator, you'd install a breaker there. This is a safety switch, so it only allows you to do one input at a time. So you could do generator or grid, but not both. One of these 50 amps goes to my 50 amp RV hookup. The other 50 amp actually comes over to this box. It's the reason why I left the cover off. Those wires go through the back into here and to this breaker right here. Now, this originally was where I switched back and forth from solar and grid, but now that I have this installed, and that will do it, I don't need to do it on this panel, so I took that switch out, and now the smart home panel comes in here, and then it distributes to this box, which is everything in this room. Now, the other rooms are on the other breakers in there. This breaker actually goes to my house box. My house box is down below here, and then this actually goes way over to the main house breaker, and that allows me to power my entire house off of the Delta Pro Ultras. Now, I'm not going to do that in this video, but I'm going to do that in a follow-up video. So while this does sound very complicated, it is actually all very easy to do, and that app is really fantastic. And since this sucker's electrical, it's far safer than gas, propane, or diesel generators. There's no exhaust pipes to run outside, there's no fuel to store or leak, no chance of carbon monoxide poisoning. And unlike a gas generator, this can be installed entirely indoors and it's so quiet that you can even sleep in the same room. Now, doing that with a fuel generator of any kind would not just be annoying, but deadly. The install, however, didn't go perfectly. I did end up wasting a solid half hour because nowhere in the instructions and any of the manuals I got from Ecoflow does it say that this faceplate right here needs to be installed before the thing would work. Now, I was running it just like I run this one. When you do testing in electrical circuits, you just have the panel off so you can see what's going on. You can access things. You can check the temperatures of the wires and things like that. So I was testing this with this panel missing. Now, this door isn't required and this comes right off. But I didn't think that this panel was required. So I left it off and I was literally pulling my hair out and I got a lot of hair over like a 30-minute period trying to figure out why the heck is this thing not working. Well, there's a little micro switch up here that detects that this panel's in place. If it's not in place, none of it works. Probably because of this, it's a safety feature. When you install this thing, if it's not working, it's because you didn't put the panel in. And since I did mention that this outer swing door is optional, it can be mounted on either side. I'm deciding just to keep it factory opening to the left. Other flubs during install. Don't forget about the Cat 6 cable that needs to go into the hole underneath and into the main panel. Now, the guy I had doing the install completely forgot about this until after the conduit was ran, because we were gonna run everything through this black PVC conduit. Instead, we ended up running it outside the conduit all the way up and into the box in the next room. Now, fortunately, since my install is indoors, we don't have to be concerned about weatherproofing or rodents chewing cables or anything like that. And we decided just to go with this cheap, easy 2-inch PVC pipe that's unglued because I am going to want to run additional cabling for an upcoming project. And 2-inch pipes made it pretty easy to run that big, thick cable through these 90-degree turns. I use 6-gauge 3-conductor non-metallic cable and an electrical speak that's 6-3 NMB cabling. The cable I got ran about $4 a foot, so don't forget to factor that cost into your installation. Now, what about installation costs? Now, for me here in rural Arizona, it ran about $700 for parts and labor to run the DPU box about 25 feet from the home panel. And I had to rewire several circuits from inside the wall. And we actually took this wall apart. You can see it still needs to be made pretty. We'll do that later. We took some of the circuits out of the wall and put them into this box. Now, this same job in California would probably be about double the price. It would also be a lot more expensive if this was an outdoor install. Then again, if you plan to keep the DPU and home panel in the same location, like if I want to put everything right here, then parts and labor costs would be minimal. Ecoflow states in their documentation that it takes about 4 hours to install. And that sounds about right if you're putting everything in one place and the electrician that you have goes gangbusters on it. And speaking of regulations, some electricians won't touch anything that's not UL listed. Fortunately, the Smart Home Panel 2 is UL 1741 certified, so getting it installed by a professional won't be a problem. And in the states of California and Texas, Ecoflow is offering free consulting to find you an installer. All right, now let's move on to what this thing can do and demonstrate all the major features. This thing is a very impressive piece of technology. This is the bottom half of the Smart Home Panel 2, and you can see it goes through this conduit and that follows that wiring all the way to the box. Now you can plug in up to 3 Delta Pro Ultras or Delta Pros in here. Now this does support the old Delta Pro as well as the new Delta Pro Ultra. Now when you're running Delta Pro Ultras, each one of these inputs is an additional 7 kilowatts. So you got 1 at 7 kilowatts, 2 is 14 kilowatts, and 3 is 21 kilowatts. That's a lot of inverter power. Now, how many batteries you have depends on how many batteries you decide to get with your system. This actually has 12 kilowatt hours of batteries. However, this is not hooked up to my house right now. This is hooked up to just this building, which is about 400 square feet. And I do have lots of power use in here because I'm always charging power stations. Plus, this powers my RV. So let me show you down here the Delta Pro Ultra. So this is the Delta Pro Ultra with the 2 batteries, and this unit here is running up to that box. So the way I have this hooked up right now is it is charging from the solar port from a 48-volt battery, while it's also supplying all the loads in this entire building. And you're going to notice something. I'm sitting right next to it. It's making absolutely no noise whatsoever. This is dead silent under 2 kilowatts, which is going to be probably what your loads are a lot of the time, less than 2 kilowatts. Another cool thing about the Delta Pro Ultra, which I only found out after using it for a few days with the Smart Home Panel 2, is that these batteries will self-balance themselves. So if you hook up multiple inverters and multiple batteries, they will all relatively balance themselves out. So you're not gonna have one that's 90% and one that's 10%. It'll kind of balance it to like 70-30, or 40-60, so that when you're trying to pull large loads, it'll pull pretty much evenly from all the batteries. That's something that the older systems and competitors don't do. Now, because these units do balance themselves, that means you can pump more power into one than the other. For example, each Delta Pro Ultra head unit has 2 solar inputs. One of them is low PV, the other one's high PV. Combined, they can take up to 5,600 watts of solar each. So for every Delta Pro Ultra inverter head unit, you can input 5,600 watts of solar. The low input can take 30 to 150 volts, while the high input would take 80 to 450 volts. Now this is simultaneous input. This is more than double the solar capacity of competing flagships. Now if you want a comprehensive review of this product, I've already done one back in January. Be sure to check out my full technical review on this product. I will put a link up here at the top of the screen and also in the description of this video. And as for the elephant in the room, yes, I am using an Ecoflow power kit. So I'm gonna do a separate review on this next month. Now I'm also planning to hook that into the Smart Home Panel system. How? Well, you just have to watch that video and find out. Now the Delta Pro Ultras along with the Smart Home Panel 2 can all be controlled through Ecoflow's wonderful app. But that app requires internet access. What if you don't want to use internet access? What if you want to install this in a location that does have internet, or you're one of those people that hates using the internet? Well, they have this addition, which you can get along with the Smart Home Panel 2. It's called the Power Insight. Basically, it's a big Android tablet that runs a specialized piece of software on here that allows you to do all kinds of cool stuff, monitor the system, change some settings. Now, unlike the app, this does not require internet access. You get all the information about your system all in one place. Now, this piece of technology can be hung on the wall. It comes with a mounting bracket, which is powered by USB-C, and it's magnetically held on the back. So you can see right here, it comes right off, and then when you go to hang it back up on the wall again, it just magnetically sticks back on and holds the tablet. And that means you can take this off and use it anywhere on your property. You can even run other connected home appliances with it, like smart plugs, thermostats, and matter-supported smart devices. It also shows up in the corner the local temperature and humidity of the area that it's in. So you might be wondering, okay, this system is going to be pretty pricey. What about return on my investment? How long is it going to take for this stuff to pay itself off? Now, I do have a couple days worth of data in this system. Let's take a closer look at what I've run over the last few days. Okay, here is the power insight in real time. These are real loads that are currently being run. You can see that 48 volt battery is charging right now at 766 watts. The output is 551 watts. So you can actually click on all of these and it will show you what's going on. Right now I have 54% on my Delta Pro Ultra that's hooked up. You can see the circuits. So here we have the 50 amp RV hookup. These are the outlets in my other room that I had built onto this recently. Lab main is this room and everything in it, including the mini split and the lights, which I just turned the lights off so the power went down a little bit. These other circuits I'm not currently using. Across the bottom of the screen, you can see solar charging. You can click on that, and this allows you to change the percentage of backup reserve power in your system. So you can make this slider up to 50% or down to 10%. And I have mine set at 25% just because I am doing some testing. Now, say you have this hooked up to the grid and solar. The lower you put this percent, the more money you're going to save, because that means it's going to use the batteries more than the grid. Now, here is the different savings modes. I currently have it on self-powered. Now, this is how most people would have it set up, where it pulls solar in and grid power. And this would be if you have a fixed rate plan. Scheduled tasks allow you to manually tell it at certain times of the day you want to charge or discharge. TOU mode is actually if you have a time of use rate plan, like you want it to charge at night when it's cheap and then run during 5 o'clock in the evening or something when it's more expensive. So if you have a time of use plan, this would be very handy for you. Now, like I said, I've only had this running for a couple of days and it's not really pulling a bunch of loads, but it says I saved $4. And you can go click in here and it'll give you a chart, and we can go back to yesterday when I was actually doing more battery stuff. Monday, I was doing a lot of my testing that day. So you can see I had solar coming in. It tells you by the hour how much solar comes in. And you can click on each one and say, okay, at this particular time, I pulled in 1.4 kilowatt hours. Click on home. It tells you how much power you used. Since midnight last night, I've used 11.5 kilowatt hours for this building. And I know that sounds like a lot. It is, because I do actually do a lot of stuff in here. As for the battery, you can see how much of the battery did you discharge on this day. And it goes hour by hour. At this particular time during the day, I discharged 1.03 kilowatt hours from the battery. Grid power. Let me find out when I had a blackout. You can see down here it says total outage duration. The power was out for just over 2 hours the other day, and that was on the 25th. It was out for 2 hours and 9 minutes. That was due to a storm that we had coming through here. So now I remember why there was this spike in power. The blackout happened right around 6 p.m., so it was running on battery power during these 2 hours, and then on the third hour, I brought an Ecoflow Delta in to charge, and so that used up a lot of the battery power, and then the next day, it actually charged from solar. So anyway, you can see the level of detail that you actually can get in this thing, and it even tells you how much money you're going to save. So you can actually tell it how much it costs you per kilowatt hour, and for here, it's 13 cents per kilowatt hour after taxes and everything. So it says that so far, since I've had this hooked up, I saved $4. So yeah, I only had a couple days of data in here, and this is just for a small building. I can hear the comments already. Only $4? A thing costs thousands of dollars. You only save $4. Well, you have to remember, that's only like a day and a half of data for one small outbuilding. So here's like the big thing with the smart home panel and the Delta Pro Ultra system. Yeah, it's a large upfront investment, but in the long run, it will save you a lot of money if you have it set up properly. Especially if you have a time of use plan where you can charge it when it's cheap and then run it when your electricity is normally expensive. And you also don't have to worry about rolling blackouts anymore, or thunderstorms or hurricanes or anything like that that could possibly knock out your power. And you have to think too, that $4 that I saved is going into my own pocket instead of going to a utility company, which is just going to raise rates over time. Electricity is not going to get cheaper. It's going to get more expensive. There's going to be more taxes added to it. And they can pretty much control your utilities. They can have rolling blackouts whenever they feel like it. They can shut off your electricity whenever you feel like it. You get a system like this, and you don't have to worry about that anymore. So bring on those monsoon thunderstorms. I'm ready for you. So we had that blackout the other day. The smart home panel too kicked in immediately. There was no blinking lights or anything like that. It just immediately switched over to battery power, which was pretty fantastic. And then I got a notification on my phone that the grid was down and that Ecoflow was taking care of my power situation. And I thought that was pretty cool that I got a notification on my phone that the grid was down. Now, in a system like this, obviously the more load you power via solar and the higher your electric rates are, the faster you're going to be able to roll back that electric meter. And especially if you have that time of use system, because the smart home panel does let you charge from the grid when rates are the lowest. Add some solar charging into that equation, and yes, you get this system set up properly, it can literally pay for itself over time. Especially when you factor in the current solar tax credits and the ability to deduct about a third of the cost. Now, if you have a medical and necessity like a CPAP machine or oxygen concentrator, you may qualify for additional tax deductions, and for that information you have to check with your tax professional. One thing that's really cool about these solar incentives is that you could install your basic system this year and say next year you realize you need some more batteries or you need additional inverters. You can take those same deductions again the following year for your new equipment. So it's not like it's a one-time thing. You can claim solar tax credits every year that you buy stuff that basically connects to your home that's solar or batteries or inverters or solar controllers or anything like that. And that, of course, includes this Ecoflow system. Do I think buying the smart home panel 2 is a wise investment if you're planning on plugging one or more of the Delta Pro Ultras or Delta Pros into the wiring for your home, cabin, business, or off-grid property? Now, that's really going to depend. First, the Smart Home Panel 2 does require dual-phase 240-volt grid power to fully function. Now, what I mean by that is that you can technically run the panel from a 120-volt source through that generator input that I mentioned earlier. At the top of the panel, there's that manual safety switch, which is built in that lets you switch from grid to generator for charging the batteries. Now, I'm told that in 120-volt mode, that only half of the circuits will work, but it will in fact charge all of the attached Delta Pro Ultras or Delta Pro unit batteries from 120 volts. So it is technically possible to use this panel totally off the grid if you have a 120 or 240 volt power source besides the grid. That could be a gas generator or even another inverter system. And since the panel is designed with grid tie in mind, it is expecting this source to be available 24 hours a day. Now, I'm going to spill the beans right now and give you a hint that I will cover this scenario next month when I run the Ecoflow power kits into this thing as a 120 volt generator. And then we're going to find out then just how well it works. So if you do have typical 240 volt grid service, I'd say this thing is magical and definitely worth the cost, especially if you plan on running more than one Delta Pro Ultra into it, as it's simply the best, safest, and fastest way to dump grid power into these units and get it back exactly when you need it or at your beck and call. It's just super awesome to open up your phone, open the app, push a button, and have complete control of the power in your home. And you can see what every circuit is doing, and that is what is wild. Okay, now say you live totally off the grid without 240 volt service and only plan to use a single Delta Pro Ultra to power a limited number of loads, or you already have a transfer switch system in place, then you'll need to figure out if the upgrade cost of the home panel 2 is worth it to you. I think in a lot of cases it still will, and in some cases it won't. For example, if you just feed one DPU into a transfer switch and only have it charged with solar, then the home panel won't really make a lot of sense. And what I've been using here in my lab for the past year or so is a manual transfer switch that would let me swap between grid power and inverter power. That inverter power used to be a Renogy Lycan, but is now the Ecoflow power kit. I had to disable that setup for this install, so now I'm stuck using Ecoflow products to power my lab. And that's okay, because they're always very responsive when it comes to issues. I can always spend 15 or 20 minutes twisting a screwdriver to put that old transfer switch back in place. Now, there's one conclusion to this, and that means we're certainly going to be doing some long-term updates on this product in 2024 and maybe even beyond. So if you're interested in the Smart Home Panel 2 or bundle deal with one or more of the Delta Pro Ultra Solar Generators, I do have a discount code available that's going to knock a huge chunk of change off only until April 26, 2024. And after that, you're on your own. So if you're concerned that you can't pay for this entire system in one go, because it's not cheap, Ecoflow does offer financing for the first 6 months, interest-free, which is a big deal with today's interest rates. Don't forget to claim those tax incentives as well, as that'll make this system a lot more affordable in the long run. The link with the discount code is gonna be in the description of this video below. I'll also put a link here at the bottom of the screen along with a QR code that you can scan if you're watching me on TV, that'll take you on over to the Ecoflow store page where you can check out the Delta Pro Ultra and Smart Home Panel 2. Thanks for watching. If you learned something today, don't forget to give me that thumbs up below. And if you're not a subscriber already, you know what to do. That's it for now. Till next time.
Odin commands you to like and subscribe and clean my litter box. RV Golf Guy, Brian Loop, Bruce Johnson, Jason Sirocco, Mark Stevenson.